Captain of the Guard, report.
Sentries, attention. Sentries, report. North sentry.
Clear, sir.
South sentry.
Clear, sir.
East sentry.
Clear, sir.
West sentry.
Clear, sir.
All clear, sir.
We come today to dedicate our families, our faith tradition, who we are to the Lord Jesus Christ. We remember those days when worship was circumscribed and limited, when we could not express fully our love for the Lord and the truths of the gospel, when our families worshiped in fear. But today we lift up our tartans representing all that is good in our tradition and our faith. And so I ask all here to now lift up your tartans and let us hang them together to the glory of God and in honor of all we remember and all we call good. Let us pray. Lord, we lift up our tartans to you in praise, and we ask that you would bless our families, our church, our nation, and Lord, bless each individual who is here today to say, yes, Lord, and to lift up the tartans that show forth our traditions and our faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Good morning, fellow Scots.
Good morning.
Let us join together reverently for a prayer. On behalf of all Scots away from Scotland, and in the name of all Scottish clansfolk, and representing all the faithful here gathered, we present these tartans before Almighty God in appreciation of our heritage, and we ask his blessings upon these, his humble servants. O Lord, thou hast promised that in all places where thou recordest thine holy name, thou wilt meet with thy servants and bless them. Fulfill now thy promise. Make us joyful in our prayer, so that our worship, being offered in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and by the guidance of thy Holy Spirit, may be acceptable unto you and profitable unto ourselves. Bless, we pray, these tartans, that they may be unto us and unto all people a token of the faith of our fathers and a sign of our service unto you. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let the pipes play our dedication to the Lord and our freedom in Jesus Christ. Let us hear the tolling of the hour. And let us stand. As we hear together the prayer of John Knox, as we offer it in unison.
O Lord, strengthen our faith, kindle it more fervently, and love towards thee and our neighbors for thy sake. Suffer us not, most dear Father, to receive thy word any more in vain, but grant us always the assistance of thy grace and Holy Spirit, that in heart, word, and deed, we may sanctify and we worship to thy name. Amen.
You may be seated. We welcome all who are here worshiping today. We are one family in the name of Jesus Christ. The Lord has a purpose for your being here today. And that goes for those who are watching virtually or by drive-up. You are part of what the Lord intends for his children on this day and into our lives. Please text me any joys and concerns you might have. My number is on the insert in your bulletin. And if you have one, text it to me now, because we're offering joys and concerns at the beginning of worship today. Also, I want to thank the St. Andrew Society for joining us this Sunday for the Kirkin of the Tartans, for partnering with us. We appreciate the posting of their banners along with ours, and we appreciate their contributions to the community and to the community of faith. We also thank the Fellowship Committee and the Worship Committee for having a preception before worship and then one following worship. Please join us. And please give a special embrace to those who are our guests and our visitors who are part of our family today. Well, the last 2 weeks, Susie and I have hosted Meet and Eats for lunch. And boy, we have shocked and surprised 2 restaurants so far. The people just kept coming both times. Now, there is one final, and this is one of our last opportunities to have fellowship together with the family we love so much here at Lafayette. That's this Friday, and it is at 6 o'clock at the Southwood Golf Club, and we'll have dinner together. And those who wish to stay a little longer, there will be live music beginning at 7. So please, even if you've been to both previous, you're welcome to come to this one. If you haven't been to one so far, that's the Southwood Golf Club at 6 o'clock Friday. We would love to share fellowship with you. And now Susie will offer joys and concerns.
For our joys and concerns, Pam Terry asks that we pray for Juan, who is a dear friend of their daughter Dana and her husband Cesar, who had a stroke this past week. We also want to pray for Colleen McConnell, who is having serious health issues. Please pray for our adopted granddaughter Hope Downing, who has COVID. And please pray for wife Beth and the family of Pastor Hugh Lackey. He followed Steve at St. Cloud as the interim pastor. Pastor Hugh died suddenly shortly after conducting the funeral service for our friend Tom Dabrowski yesterday afternoon. Please keep them all in your prayers.
And we have a praise report. Bonnie Burns asks that we celebrate with them that Shelby came for the weekend and they had a wonderful time. And pray for Jaya over in Apalachicola. She's not feeling well and everyone's starting to worry. And also, we are really privileged. For some of you, you may be hearing about this for the first time, but you know that I took transitional ministry training. And one of the things that they stressed in transitional ministry training is that even while things are changing and we're looking to the future for vision, it's important to have some stability, especially in worship. And so the pulpit won't provide that stability right away. There will be different folks preaching on different Sundays. But our music department, with our wonderful choir and our leader, Stephen Olson, they will be taking on higher responsibility. They will, in essence, be the worship leaders, the consistent worship leaders of our congregation. And to that end, the session saw the wisdom in offering a scholarship internship to a music student at Florida State who will assist Stephen in his new increased duties and will direct for him in his absence and may even be able to substitute for Serena if she isn't able to be there, so that every Sunday we will have consistency for the choir, for the leadership, for our music department. And so we welcome Lafayette's first scholarship intern for our music department, Aiden O'Brien. Aiden, could you please stand? Welcome. And choir, yes, I've already asked the question. She will sing with the choir. Let us continue the worship of Almighty God.
Amen.
Let us now call ourselves to worship. O Christ, you are a bright flame before me. You are a guiding star above me.
You are the light and love I see in others' hearts.
Keep me, O Christ, in a love that is tender.
Keep me, O Christ, in a love that is true. Keep me, O Christ, in a love that is strong, today, tomorrow, and always. Amen.
In body or in spirit, please stand now for our hymn of praise, All People That on Earth Do Dwell.
As it was in body, made me, is now and that was beautiful. Amen. Our scripture reading for today comes from Matthew chapter 4, verses 12 through 17. Now when Jesus heard that John had been arrested, he withdrew to Galilee. He left Nazareth and made his home in Capernaum by the sea, in the territory of Zebulun and Naphtali, so that what had been spoken through the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled. Land of Zebulun and Naphtali, on the road by the sea, across the Jordan. Galilee of the Gentiles, the people who sat in darkness have seen a great light. And for those who sat in the region and shadow of death, light has dawned. From that time, Jesus began to proclaim, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near." This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let us pray. Lord, we ask that you would write these words of scripture on our hearts, that we might find their place in our lives. Amen. The kingdom of God is at hand. We only know what we know. We comprehend only that which we have experienced. When Jesus came into the world, even with the guidance of the law and the prophets, life was devoid of truth, of divine truth, and sunk in ignorance and sin. They didn't know any better. They were accustomed to the darkness, as are we. We rarely imagine beyond the limitations of our training, our education, our routines, or the environment in which we live. Did you know that for 12,000 years, human beings only had clubs and spears for hunting and for conflict? It took 12,000 years before someone figured out a bow and arrow. And then it was 5,000 years until the next advancement. Why? Because it's so hard to see past what we have, what we are, who we are. That's why we smile when we look at an episode of Star Trek and we see that the computers that they looked forward to with great anticipation were still huge hunking things in the corner behind the sliding door that didn't have 1,000th the computing power of this cell phone. At least they did come up with flip phones. I'll give them that. But you see, even looking ahead is a challenge when we only know where we've been. We don't know where we're going. When we were children, we thought we knew what we liked. Cotton candy was great. How could we even visualize the delicious delights of a prime rib? Drinking Kool-Aid, how could we have known the pleasures of a fine wine? And my personal revelation, eating Hershey's chocolate, how could we have possibly imagined Cadbury's? Left to our own devices and desires, we would tend to live in darkness, the darkness of ignorance. the darkness that is born of our griefs, the darkness which creeps up on us as our bodies begin to fail us and our capabilities diminish, the darkness of being underappreciated or seeing others promoted or lauded for less than we've contributed, the shadows of loneliness, the pain of separation, the tears of goodbye. But take heart. The prophecies have been fulfilled. The people who live in darkness will see a great light. In Jesus Christ, a new light has dawned. It's not death. It's the birth pangs of new life. Oh, the kingdom of God is near. Do you know what that is literally in the Greek? It means the kingdom of God is at hand. And in Greek, that means the kingdom is already here, it's come, but it's also always arriving. It's always bringing something new. It is here and present in Jesus Christ. It's visible and obvious in his preaching, teaching, and healing. But the kingdom is also arriving and will continue to arrive over and over again. The kingdom is always here, but always bringing something new. We revere our Scottish Presbyterian ancestors, and we respect the traditions of the church and the tartan. We are proud that it was our church, our people, who brought the concepts of freedom and democracy to the United States and thereby shaped its very form of government. But none of this would have been possible without light breaking through. You see, the light of the gospel led John Knox and others to see the world in a new light. Suddenly it was clear, freedom in Christ must be manifested by freedom in our faith, freedom in our lives, freedom in our culture. But the kingdom is relentless. It will always be arriving, always new. And the light of Christ continued to bring change. Our nation has had to adapt over centuries to new realities and new concepts of equality and justice. Our church has continued to evolve and change, and it has continued to reform to meet needs our forebears couldn't even have imagined. Even in the relatively short history of Lafayette Presbyterian, could the charter members in 1947 have foreseen our worship style, the way we dress, or the music that we offer in worship? Could they have envisioned today's church with people of all races, creeds, and colors gathered here today? We are about to enter a time of transition, my friends. Yes, I will, my family will, and my beloved Lafayette family will be facing a time of transition. And there will be shadows cast by goodbyes and separation, by new realities, and by challenging choices. But it's not death. In Jesus Christ, it is the birth pangs of new life. It is a light that reminds us we were never meant to stay where we are. It's not the church's mission to continue to repeat what we've always done or to only go where we've gone before. I rejoice in the truths of the gospel. The light shines in the darkness. The Lord will lead us out of the shadows. Yes, we will honor our heritage and our tradition. We will build on the foundation of faith and raise our tartans to the Lord. But in Christ, we will discover new patterns and new possibilities. And we won't simply be living with wishes, hopes, and promises. The Lord will bring blessings beyond what we've known. We won't have to drink the Kool-Aid when the Lord brings living water. The bread that might be offered by a pastor will be superseded by the very bread of life. Wherever we've grown accustomed to Hershey's, God will bring us Cadbury. The kingdom of God is at hand. Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for the advent of your kingdom and for the new possibilities that new light brings. In Jesus' name we pray.
Affirmation of faith.
Please stand.
Please stand. God made the world and all its creatures, with men and women made in his image.
By breaking his laws, people have broken contact with God and damaged his good world.
This we see and sense in the world and in ourselves.
The Bible tells us the good news that God still loves us and has shown his love immediately in his Son, Jesus Christ. He lived among us and died on the cross to save us from our sins.
In his love, this living Jesus invites us to turn from our sins and enter by faith into a restored relationship with God, who gives true life before and beyond death.
In Jesus' name, we gladly share with our neighbors God's message for all people. You matter to God. Amen.
Please remain standing as we sing our hymn of proclamation, Immortal, Invisible, God Only Wise.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord, we dedicate these tithes, these offerings, these gifts to you, for you are the author of the blessed bounty that we enjoy. We pray that we would be reminded that we too often share only from our abundance. Remind us to be generous so that not only we may prosper in your word, your will, and your way, but others may find the light through our mission, our ministry, and our love. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Let us join together in our hymn of parting, Amazing Grace. Charge us to seek the light, and wherever there is darkness in our lives, even if we aren't so much aware of it, may we invite that light to shine new hope, new possibilities, and new life. And may the grace, peace, love, and mercy of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, abide with you this hour and forever. Amen. Let us receive the salute of the bagpipes.